At the Sana'a detention center, Awel, an Ethiopian, tells his story.
Someone who witnessed and experienced it.
Unemployed at home, he decided to take his chances in Saudi Arabia. His route took him across Somaliland and Djibouti to Yemen. He was taken prisoner there and tortured by traffickers before managing to escape.
They took me in front of the others who were staying there, and they started the torture. They told me I have to call and get their money now. They hung me with my fingers on the roof of the hut where we were staying. So it was very painful, really.
Most of these men have had the same horrific experience: extortion, torture, and sometimes rape. Those who were freed in April by the authorities have already returned home. This has encouraged many other migrants, left on their own, to leave the country. They have come to the Sana'a detention center, which has quickly become overcrowded. MSF launched a mental health care program there.
They are very worried about the future. They don't know what is going to happen with them. They are not. They don't know where they are going to be deported. They feel anxious because of the uncertain future. The most of them, they don't have money because they spent all of their money on during the trip. So they are very anxious because they don't know what to do when they come back to their places.
Since April, 4,000 migrants have already returned to their country of origin. However, authorities estimate that 30,000 Ethiopians are taking their chances along the Saudi Arabian border, still at the mercy of the traffickers.